Welcome to the video. Today our topic of discussion is conversion from spherical to Cartesian coordinates, Cartesian or rectangular coordinates. Many people find it difficult in converting spherical to Cartesian coordinate. Actually not in converting, they find it very difficult in visualizing the spherical coordinates and they go for the shortcut. That is, they just remember the formulas and they'll substitute it. Hope after finishing this lecture, you will be pretty sure about the visualization in 3D and you will be very clear about the concept. Now we are going to convert r theta phi into x, y, z. Let's go into it. This is our sphere and the point of reference is, this is the point I am considering, and here is our origin. This is x axis, this green one is y axis and this blue one is z axis. And distance of this point from the origin is the radius of the sphere, that is r, and this is what we call z. In z is our Cartesian coordinate. In Cartesian coordinate, this is x, this is y and this is z. And in spherical, the distance from origin to the point is r and this angle is theta and this angle is phi. Phi angle we have seen in our spherical coordinate, not spherical, in cylindrical coordinate also we have seen the phi in cylindrical and spherical coordinate is same. In spherical coordinate, we will get one more angle called theta, that is to select the circle in vertical direction. Now, the triangle which we need to consider, I have shown in a different color. So, just consider this triangle, see this triangle, how it is located. So that you will have the clarity, and if you apply the trigonometry here, cos theta, which is nothing but adjacent side by this is adjacent side, and r is the hypotenuse, that is this is z, right? Cos theta equal to z by r, this is the thing, cos theta equal to z by r and z equal to r cos theta. This is one coordinate, one relation we got. Now we'll consider another triangle, that is this triangle. See clearly how is it located. Just I am showing only half of the sphere so that you won't get confused with the other half. And this angle is pi by 2 minus theta, right? See, this complete angle will be pi by 2. This angle is pi by 2. And we are already having theta here, so this is pi by 2 minus theta. And the same thing, this is the distance, this is the distance, these are arbitrary distance which we will get here. Suppose I am taking this as some t, so same as the above, we apply the trigonometry, cos of pi by 2 minus theta equal to adjacent side, that is t by hypotenuse, that is r, here comes. Cos of pi by 2 minus theta is adjacent side t, that is the intermediate variable t by r, t equal to r sin theta. Now we will find out the x and y coordinates. Now consider this triangle, that is this triangle which is located on xy plane, and we have found out this distance, right? That is the intermediate variable t, we know this t and we know this phi. So if we apply again trigonometry here, cos phi equal to this distance, that is x, by hypotenuse is t. So cos phi equal to x by t, and we know t is r sin theta, so x equal to, generally x is t cos phi, and we have substituted r sin theta in the place of t, so x is r sin theta cos phi. In the same way, if we apply sin phi is y by t, and y equal to t sin phi, t is r cos theta, sorry, r sin theta. So y will be r sin theta into sin phi. Y is r sin theta into sin phi. So we got the three coordinates, z equal to r cos theta, x equal to r sin theta into cos phi, y is equal to r sin theta into sin phi. Hope you like the video.